Good morning, fans. PrivateerFX coming at you on Friday, 24 April. Crazy day yesterday in Euro and in Euro Yen. EU couldn't come to an agreement. Total botch in the end. So you can see, open the day straight down. As we know, we took a long position at 38, stopped out 18, watched it go down to 75, got long again at 40, watched it print 82, scratched all the way down 115.65. Crazy. What it means in the longer term is shit is offered. Should be resistance today at 116.20. But you got to watch the news, right? This is all news driven. This wasn't technically driven. It wasn't flow driven. This was news driven. So news is driving the bus here. We are not short Euro Yen, but Euro Yen does look bad. Dollar CAD also had a very interesting day. Broke down through that 141.15 area. Quadruple bottom here. Quick 100 points down to 140.06. This should be resistance up here, 141.15 again. And CAD yen also trading kind of with the oil price, which was very, very bid. CAD yen above 40 looks interesting. It's not super clear, this bar. Higher daily low, higher daily high, but we have a bit of a wick up here. I do like CAD yen higher. I imagine just by talking about the charts we just talked about, Euro CAD must be getting crushed. Yeah, Euro CAD looks quite bad as well. 151.22 is a very interesting point. Euro CAD is kind of the best of Euro dollar downside and dollar CAD downside. We should take a look at this. One of the problems with Euro CAD is liquidity. Let's see what the spreads are right now. Euro CAD, 2.6 wide. It's from JP Morgan, a little bit early, but the problem with Euro CAD is liquidity. It should be much tighter than that. If you think about it, Euro dollar is basically choice, dollar CAD is basically a half a tick wide. Why the hell is Euro CAD so wide? But it always is. So be careful with your execution. It's a little bit more tricky than a lot of people are used to. Can we start the party at 151.40 today, or do we want to just kind of feather into some high ones? Not sure. I have to give that some thought. Euro CAD looks interesting. What else is going on? Dollar yen stuck. BOJ comment they're going to buy unlimited, and they're going to add corporate and commercial paper to their already unlimited buying. This has been a cock blocker. Looks really offered, looks really bid, looks really offered, looks really bid. We think 108.06 is the bingo number on the top side. No idea if we're going to see that. Dollar yen just been shitty, right? Stuck here between 107 and 108 now for 9 days. So the longer we're here, the more powerful the breakout will be. And you kind of know the parameters, right? It's 106.90 and now 108.08 for the number files out there. Any Chinese dudes will love that shit. They love their eights, 108.08. That looks to be kind of fun. What else is out there? We don't really care about the news flow today. Let's talk about gold. Freaking hard. Bid. We talk about trying to be long, but we're not long. every day we talk about trying to be long, but we're not long. I think gold's probably going to go to 5,000. No joke. So I got to figure out what to do with this. Waiting for pullbacks, waiting for silliness. Maybe I'm just going to buy it through the highs, up through 2,000 or something, and watch it run. Run like it's never run before. Belmont Stakes style. Stocks, we talked about how they couldn't hold their bid yesterday. Further selling last night, down to 55. Now we're in the middle of nowhere, so if you're short yesterday from 2810 area, you can hold those. I don't think we're going to revisit that. Otherwise, you want to sell high ones today. The Euro ball kicking the balls just adds to the crappiness of what's going on out there. So we like to sell high ones in ES. And if you run a trend book, you just want to be short ES. Crude, everyone's short. Everyone's trying to sell rallies. Everyone's so scarred by this minus 40 deal. That's why we're going higher. You know, nobody's long, everybody's short, so we continue to go higher. Trade this at your own risk. It looks pretty calm. This chart looks pretty calm, right? But just think of, you know, the reason that these bars look so tiny is because of that minus 44. If we make it bigger, it doesn't really help. But these are $2 bars, 118.16 down to 115.86. That's a two-hour, four-hourly bar. If you look at the one-hour bar, these bars look tiny, but they are not tiny. 118.29, 115.82, 117.60, 116.60. That's a $1 hourly bar. Hysterically difficult to trade, but it's bid. I have no idea why. I don't begin to understand what the hell's going on in gold. I mean, in oil, but shit's bid. And this is why we like dollar CAD lower. And this is why we like CAD yen higher. But we're not long gold. Or we're not long oil. Sorry, getting as confused. Finally, dollar Norway. Those 77s paid pretty well. We traded down to 53. Back up to 67. So, you know, 2,000 points down, 1,400 points up. This is dollar Norway. Pretty volatile stuff. You want to sell high ones again. This fits in with our oil higher idea. And for now, with euro dollar collapsing, it's going to be hard for dollar Norway to collapse, but we do think this is that will turn eventually. But the Norwegian side should carry the day here, and quietly short dollar Norway is one of our favorite trades. Dollar Swiss, same thing. Sell between 55 and 75, buy between 15 and the figure. Now guess what? We're going to sell again today between 70 and 90. The trend book is short, but the tactical book today will try and scavenge some pips, selling high ones in dollar Swiss and dollar Norway. So to sum up where we are here, we're long CAD. We like buying CAD yen dips. We're looking at this Euro CAD downside and CAD yen upside. These are key tactical ideas for the day. Euro yen looks like crap, but we're not going to touch it. Total fuck job yesterday. 141.15 should be resistance. Dollar CAD. I've said enough for Friday. Wish you guys a good trading day ahead. I will talk to you on Monday. Have a good weekend. Ciao.